Hey everybody, it's Lego Jang here with a look at the Maersk Train. It was the Lego Club or Lego Shop at Home exclusive, and this was set number 10219. You can see it on the train engine itself. It had 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces, 1,234 pieces. Now, interestingly enough, when you open up, this is an advanced set. It's intended to be for ages 14 and up, although younger kids can tackle this. But when you open it up, the bags are numbered as usual, but they're only numbered 1 and 2. So there's a whole stack of bags numbered 1, and there's a whole stack of bags numbered 2. All of the, it's roughly half and half the parts between the two sets. All of the parts from all of the number 1 bags go into just creating the engine. So a lot of complexity is right here, where while your number 2 bags go into creating all of these things over here, 3 containers, a full truck, 2 full train cars. So it's an interesting distribution of parts. I was able to split this up, and I did the build of just the engine. My girlfriend actually built all these other things, and we finished it almost at the same time. Really cool looking set. Let's go ahead and look at the individual components. First off, the minifigs. You get 3 minifigs with this set, and they're all nearly identical. The only thing that is different between them is the head piece. They all have the same torso, the same legs, the same hat. And it's the exclusive Maersk blue colored hat that is not used for any other sets. Beneath the high visibility orange vest pieces that go over the torso, you will find also a printed torso piece. And again, that's shared between all 3. Okay, so that takes care of the minifigs. I'll get those out the way. I'm gonna save the core train part for the end, and I'm gonna start with a closer look at this combination of 2 things right here. If you have not lived around an area where there are ports, large ports, you may not recognize this style of truck. If you've been around a port, you've seen these by the dozens and dozens and dozens. They're actually very, very common, even though it's very odd to look at. But interestingly, these are not designed to be used on public roads. So in real life, these would not have any license plates on them, because they're only used for the most part at ports or other yards where you get a whole lot of cargo coming in and out. And these just take the cargo containers with one of these trailers. I'll just go ahead and put one of the containers on it right now. It'll take it off the ship, a large ship coming into port. And there's a big crane that comes and drops the thing on the container. One of these little tractors, they're called yard, it depends upon where you are. They're called the different things: yard tractors, port tractors, terminal tractors, shunters. They're designed to be really easy to get in and out of. In the real ones, a person would, or the operator would just walk right up here, so it's easy steps to get in, get right into the cab. You have good visibility all the way around, so when you're backing up to pick up one of these trailers, it just backs right in, and then it will actually have a hydraulic lift that'll lift up. The fifth wheel will actually lift up and pull the whole thing around. Worth looking into, do a little bit of Googling around, check out some images and some videos to see how these things work. They're very interesting, and they're very purpose-built. But what we've got here in the Lego version is great. I'm not going to go into talking about this too much more. You can see it. I'm sure there are hundreds and hundreds of photos of this truck and the other components of this set online, but this is a great, great representation, a great replica of what the real things look like. Like I said, just needs to not have the license plates on there for a little bit more realism, but a great looking thing. I absolutely love this. This is probably my second favorite component of the set by a short margin, because this is truly great. It even has these mud flaps on it. And then you have the trailer here, and you already saw that the trailer is designed. You can actually drive this right up and then just turn this under the little stand, and that gives you a nice easy way to drive right off. And the containers slip right on the top, so it's very easy to move them back and forth. These containers look great. They have opening doors at the end, and there's tons of space in there. You can put all kinds of things in there. It's got the logos. This is something that I don't like about these containers, and also a few other places on this set. You'll find sticker over assembly, so sticker over multiple things. We've got three bricks here on either side that are covered each set of three by one sticker. So this is all one sticker over 1, 2, 3 bricks. This is all one sticker over 1, 2, 3 bricks. So very, very specialized right there. And not my favorite way of doing things. The trailer looks pretty good. This area back here, I'm not the biggest fan of this area. I wish they had left this a little bit thinner, a little more Spartan in that area. It doesn't need to have that much thickness, but beyond that, pretty good. And I like how this works out. It makes it makes for a perfect play style. You can actually just drive that thing right in and out. And then on the containers, they actually give you one. Let me pick up another one. Two. They give you two of the gray ones, which are just regular containers, and they have a pretty good size to them. And then they give you one white one. And the white one represents a refrigerated container, also known as a reefer. No dirty jokes on that, please. It's just called a refrigerator, and there's a slang term for it in the transportation world. You can see the refrigerator unit back here. It's a little motor. I think those are powered by natural gas or propane, one of the two. They give you good detail here. They had to use a sticker for this one piece. These are printed pieces over on the side. Actually, was this a sticker? I didn't build this. This actually looks like it was a printed piece. So I may be mistaken. All printed pieces there, that's a sticker. That's a sticker, again, over 1, 2, 3 pieces. Those are stickers. So a lot of use of stickers were really necessary for the realism across this entire set. Let me put the container is back onto the train cars for a moment, and then move on to actually talking about the train cars. It's a low hauler, which can be used in either of these two configurations. You can place one container down low in the base, or you can place two of them, in this case, end to end. To accomplish that, you do need to add in one additional little adapter assembly here. This 2x2x2 1/3 little block. You have to set that on the center just to give a center support for these to work together. But they look great. The cars themselves look really good when they're whether they're loaded or not. I think that's just an appropriate look. Ideally, they would hold the load lower. Ideally, the containers, they would give you a 40-foot container. These are equivalent to like 20-foot containers, and two of them back to back. 40-foot container would be the length of the entire thing and would just fit on top. I believe they can actually stack two 40s on top of each other, but within the constraints of Lego scale and just making things work out, with the trailer and everything, with the minifigures, I think that this is a good look. I think that they have done well here. The containers are actually larger than I expected, and the cars look good. Again, whether you're going with the tandem configuration or just one single one down lower, you've got your little wheel for brakes here, and then with it out, it's not the greatest look right there with the holes in these bracket pieces, but not too bad. Just seeing that going by empty on a railroad is gonna look pretty good. So I'm pretty happy with these. Really can't complain much. It's just some small little things, but oops, there we go. And down she goes. All right, let's go ahead and move those aside and focus in on the biggest, baddest, most complex, most amazing thing in the set. It's the engine. There you go. This is not a recolor of the Burlington Northern Santa Fe set. This is completely redone, redesigned, specific to this set. A great looking engine, a phenomenally scale looking engine, even though they've managed to get into the normal 6-wide scale. It can fit a minifigure, just one single mini, in the cab. You can see they actually have a seat for them. Got a little control panel there. Very easy to take the upper cab off, and it's just connected by two lugs right here. That was a great idea. Very simple. Again, use of a lot of stickers, sticker, sticker, sticker. Here again, another sticker over assembly. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pieces, 8 of those small slope pieces, the 2/3 high 1x2 slope pieces, are covered by one single sticker. And you'll see a similar thing on the back, unfortunately. And I've got a little bit of air creeping under there. Similar thing here. It's an entire assembly. Personally, I really would have preferred to see a new part be made, or different design be used there, rather than putting stickers over multiple parts. I really don't like that technique in general, but it really redeems itself in just how it looks. Got the nice vents on top, large horn facing forward and back, little headlights. Oops, these lower headlights are easy to pop off, but just a really good looking cab section. It's narrow in the center here. This whole area is 4 lugs wide, and yet this is a RC capable train. You can add the Power Functions series RC components to this train. The way that they managed to get the battery box to fit in there is by adding these plates on the side. So these are actually sideways attached around the edge of a 4-wide area. So right now, the set does not come with any Power Functions. If you want to make it RC, you have to buy the sets. Move these rails, these handrails down, and take this entire side assembly off. There we go. It wants to come apart a little bit, but by default, like I say, you don't get the Power Function stuff, but you do get this scale engine. It's a scaled down 16 cylinder engine bank is what it's trying to look like. This entire unit comes out if you want to do the conversion to Power Function. So all of this will just come out, and you drop your battery box right in there. And then the receiver piece would fit. You can see the top of what would become the receiver, infrared receiver lens, and the receiver would fit right into this section in here. So pretty easy to convert. It already has the correct length of trucks down here. And they actually did extend out from the front, use some custom different work to push your plow and your coupling way out towards the end, but still looks very authentic. Nice looking fuel tank section down here, a little bit of detail in there, a little bit of different color, keeping it from being too boring. Just a great looking thing as it is. This is not something, normally I like to customize everything, and as soon as I put together a set and look at it completed for the first time, I normally say, okay, now that I've finished it, now that I've got it set for the review, now let me think about what I want to change, what I want to make better on it. And I've been looking at this one for a couple days now, since my girlfriend and I built the entire set, and I haven't come up with anything yet that I would want to change on this. I mean, if I could have had them change it before they made the set. I would prefer to not have the sticker over assembly, but that's done. That's a done deal. Those bricks are gone now, basically. There isn't anything else that I would want to change. This is just a great looking engine. It's pretty close to perfection. So that pretty much sums up my thoughts on the set, and it really comes down to just the greatness of this engine, this exclusive engine. Good looking containers and container cars, and then the shunter yard terminal port truck and its little trailer, also excellent, especially the tractor portion itself. The trailer is okay. The trailer could have been better, but the tractor is great. So definitely one of the better sets that I have that I've had my hands on yet from Lego on the whole. So many things were done right, so few things were done in a way that I thought could have been better. So I'm really, really happy with this. I'm going to try to fight my instincts of always wanting to customize things. I'm going to try to keep this one together. I might do some things on the cars, maybe. The trailer I might change a little bit, but the design of the little tractor unit is great, and the engine really needs to be left alone. Good stuff. Set number 10219. You can still find these new in package. Definitely worth getting before the costs of them get inflated too much. You will find this to be a much loved set around the world. Just great job by Lego. So that's it for my thoughts on this awesome set. Thank you very much for watching. I really enjoyed this. My girlfriend enjoyed with the assembly here. I hope that you've enjoyed it also, and I hope that you will stick around to watch more upcoming videos that will cover both set reviews and mocks, and that will span the system world as well as the large action figure world within Lego. So talk to you again soon.